drive and position is supposed to be one connection that they're doing now. And just in case you just need to focus drive. And you can switch out any of your systems to the actual one here. So if you want to test ARM using Bluetooth and running on the brick, we can do that as well. So it's just for you guys, so you can do integration testing without depending on the other routes. In case you don't trust them.
But, same question.
Yes.
This is just random sending messages, right? Or
yeah.
So even if we don't respond with a on analyze object, we could still get a new analyze object to the test code. Or
yeah. Okay. I actually added in your stub basically two options. Just basically the options for identify that you can check how often should you lock, basically not send back analyze objects and say wait for other people. And you can say it's always interesting and it's never interesting, and a certain probability that it is interesting. So you can configure stub identify to do that. This ARM is going to like that one that says it's always in practice, picking up all things. And just to get a better overview, just to shift it in a good part. Yeah. Basically, one struct for each configuration. You just set the values and pass it into it. You can compile a different set of code. Basically, just tell us which kind of situations you need, and you can sort of work it out. And it shouldn't be that much problem. For those who are interested, we have here. How we work. So we have set which devices you are on. Yeah, is there any questions by the way so far? Okay. We set this device you're on, and we say which messages forum should receive, and certain messages device should receive, and question to the position. Which message they should receive, they should receive almost. I guess they should receive everything when the messages they send themselves so they can log them. Then we create a thread for each and every one of them. And we sort of start core by entering our receive loop and forward messages over to you guys. And this is identified in this one. There's no probability of locking for 5. In 1 out of 5 situations, we will lock and respond. And in 1 out of 5, the object will be interesting. And then we'll start with the object.
Can you take that again?
Which part?
You said lock?
Yeah. Identify is where it will take too long time because it needs to be interrupted. And I didn't really know how to simulate that, so I just put in that they never respond at all.
Oh, okay.
Any questions?
Will it be a possibility to log error messages today? Like more or less like text or how? I mean.
I guess we could stop setting the objects for the failure thingy.
Yeah.
Because we have 31 bytes left. So if your error messages are shorter than that,
that should be easy enough. Yeah. If it comes down to it, it doesn't need to be more than two. Because I assume you don't have more than one error.
No.
Well, you don't have one, you can start at 0, 0.
Now we don't pack that way. We pack a byte, finally.
Oh.
So we assume it's 5. Is there anyone who thinks that this doesn't really work for your integration testing? Like, would you like to see another approach? Yes, Kim.
It's just it's not specified that we actually are receiving all of the messages you just showed us in the specification which you have written.
I would assume that the one who's logging should receive all messages.
Yes, but it was specified some these messages go to page and then not what the others was actually specified.
Yeah, I thought it was assumed. But I mean, you don't need to understand all the messages. I think you can check the specification for the messages here. There's only four times that have an actual payload. The other ones you can just read the type, and it's the same with every message. If you have the same code, you can handle every message. Basically.
Yes, but it would be nice to see the specification that is what we have to go on
okay.
when we implement our login process.
Okay. Who writes the specification? Then they can do that. But you can find things for in this file as well. .messaging.txt. It was easier to write than Adesh. If you want to know more, if you want to review it, because this is what I got from sort of our meeting. Who sees what and if it's critical or not. And basically, if it's not critical, you shouldn't do the integration testing. And you want to go to first. And then we can go from there. I had to add a few because it's really difficult to test unless you have some kind of feedback. Because if we want to test base and we want to send start mission, then we can't really know if we actually started or not. Some kind of mission is started and then back. Should we have assumed that?
Yeah.
A lot of messages. It combines most of the time spoken like that on work. We can also if you tell that we do these things that we're sharing some messages and stuff like that.
I guess I should.
They call me.
How much
the start mission is now start in some way.
Yeah, start. Can you use the identity what's called position environment? I mean, that internally. I guess there is never a start message sent in that sense. Or
between driver position.
Yeah, which should be sent start. Actually, there is because arm sends start drive whenever they want to sort of stop picking up something.
Yeah.
So you need to have that one. Mission also in a broad one, like which area should be searched. And then it gives some coding up there. Mm-hmm. I have no idea what to do that. You know.
Thank you.